Let us know. So initially what we did, so the area, average area we have calculated using this formula. Okay, mean water spread area of lake in terms of square kilometers we have calculated using this formula 2.673, because it was given in the problem that the area measured during the month of January is 2.8 square kilometers, whereas in the month of December it was found to be 2.55 square kilometers. That is nothing but what the fluctuation in the area, water spread area, is mainly due to the water loss due to evaporation. Okay, so there with the help of the pan evaporation evaporimeter, so the evaporation data which was given in this case, okay, so this is a 16.7, 14.3, 17.8, all they are measured in terms of centimeter from a evaporimeter. Okay, so now we have to calculate the evaporation using the pan coefficient. So 0.7 is the pan coefficient. So this is the, so since it is the first problem, I am explaining once again, okay, what is the concept. So pan coefficient, we have the formula, that is nothing but the ratio of lake evaporation to pan evaporation. So with the help of this, that is nothing but what, total pan evaporation, it must be pan evaporation, okay, total pan evaporation is equal to, so we can add this, so all the monthly data we have to add to get the pan evaporation. So 228.7 centimeter is nothing but what, total pan evaporation. Okay, so then lake evaporation, so this must be changed to lake evaporation. Okay, just you mention this change, so lake evaporation is equal to 0.7, so that is nothing but the pan coefficient into the total loss, water loss due to the from the pan. So that is nothing but 228.7 centimeters. So it is 160.07 centimeters. Okay, then finally we we have calculated, so that is that total water lost from the lake due to evaporation. So for the total water lost, we have to consider the area. Why? Because the pan evaporation, the lake evaporation, it is initially calculated is nothing but what, for unit area it is. Okay, for unit area. So but the area, average area or the mean area, we know. So what is that? 2.673 square kilometers. Using that area of the water spread the region, okay, so that is nothing but area into EL. Using this formula, we can be able to calculate what is the total water lost from the lake due to evaporation. Finally, it is 4.28 into 10 to the power of 6 meter cube. Okay, this is the water lost. Okay, I hope everybody understood this problem. So let us move on. I'll take the next problem. So compute the daily evaporation. Compute the daily evaporation from a class A pan if the amount of water added to bring the level to the fixed point are as follows. Water in the is the, okay, what is the evaporation loss of water in this week, okay, from a lake. Surface area of the lake is mentioned here, 640 hectares in the vicinity, assuming a pan coefficient of 0.75, assuming the pan coefficient of 0.75. Here also pan coefficient is given as well as surface area is also mentioned. So then what is the change here? So we have a table which is given here in this particular problem. So there are weekly data which is mentioned here. So first day, second day, third day, seventh day. Okay, so what is the rainfall occurred in that particular area in terms of mm, it is mentioned. As well as water, what is the amount of water added or removed to maintain the constant water level? Okay, to maintain the constant water level, because you know that in the previous class I had explained about the procedure of measurement of evaporation from a pan evaporimeter. So that is nothing but what, there is a hook gauge with the help of which we can able to measure the evaporation. Okay, depth of the water loss due to the evaporation. So we have to maintain the same water level during the or throughout our observation period. Okay, throughout our observation period. So to maintain that one, somewhere somehow it is nothing but what, somewhere we have to remove the water, or if it is an excess, or somewhere we have to add the water if it is of deficit. Okay, deficit quantity of the water is there, we have to maintain the same water level by adding. Okay, so this is what it is given here. Minus sign indicates removed and plus sign indicates it is added. Okay, so the solution here, You must know that. So pan evaporation EP in terms of mm if you are measuring, so then we have to consider this particular aspect. So that is nothing but what rainfall plus water added, or rainfall minus water removed. Okay, rainfall minus water removed. Why? Because it is nothing but what? In spite of rainfall occurred, okay, if it is very less initially, so that is nothing but what? We have to add the water to maintain the constant water level. Now, if in excess, if already the water level maintained in the evaporimeter is more, so then excess amount of the water we are gaining with the help of in the form of rainfall, so then excess amount we have to remove. So that's what. So rainfall plus water added, rainfall minus water added, so depending upon our condition. Okay, so if you use this, so we can have, so 14 minus 5 first column, so that is nothing but 9. 6 plus 3, it is 9 here. Okay, so 3 plus there is nothing but in the third row, third column, so there is no water added or removed data, so 12 as it is. Okay, so we are not going to do anything here. So in the third, fourth and as well as fifth column, sixth column, if you are considering 5 plus 4, we are considering that is nothing but 9. In the seventh column, what we are doing, 6 plus 3, we are getting 9. So we must know that. So how it is calculated using this concept. Okay, now total pan evaporation in the week. Okay, we have to consider, we have to add now. So that is nothing but what? 9 plus 9 plus 9 plus 9 plus 12 plus 8 plus 7. So we are going to get 63 mm. Okay, 63 mm. Just you check now. Sajad, can you check this? Anybody? Sandesh? Anas? Yes.
Yes, sir, 63.
Okay, correct. So pan evaporation in the week is 63 mm. So now pan coefficient formula is there with us. So 0.75, that is nothing but pan coefficient is equal to EL by EP. So lake evaporation divided by pan evaporation. So lake evaporation during the week we have to consider. So that is nothing but EL is equal to this EP. EP is nothing but what? 63, right? 63 into 0.75 we are doing. So that is nothing but what? 47.25 mm. If you are multiplying that 63 with 0.75, that is nothing but fan coefficient, we are going to get 47.25 mm. So then finally the water lost from the lake, because the area is given here, 640 hectare water spread area. So that we have to consider. Why? Because initially whatever we have calculated, this is per unit area. So area into EL, so lake evaporation. So that is nothing but 640 hectare it is, into 10 to the 4 okay, meter square, into 47.25 into 10 to the power of minus 3, because it is in mm, where we have to convert in terms of meter. Okay, so meter, so this is meter square, so ultimately the answer will be in meter cube, and the value will be 3,02,400, right? 3,02,400 meter cube is the total water lost from that water spread area, which is of 640 hectares. Okay, 640 hectares. Okay, just you note down these steps. Just you mention the problem statement first, and systematically you have to mention this with the help of table. The relevant formula we have to mention, and you finally show that answer also here at the end. So that is nothing but water loss from the lake is this much. Okay. So this getting or not? Fahim, getting? Fahim, getting?
Started.
Okay. S5M, it's over. Is Sajad Sandesh?
Sir, over.
Okay. So shall we proceed now? Yes.
Sir.
Okay, fine. So in the next problem you take, the rate of evaporation from a 1.25 meter pan having a pan coefficient of 0.8 was, the rate is given, okay, 1 mm per square meter. So as I said, it is nothing but the evaporation is measured in terms of per unit area. So that is nothing but per meter square per hour, okay, it is nothing but rate now. So find the total evaporation in a week from a reservoir having an area of 2 hectares. Area is given here, 2 hectares. So we have to calculate what is the total rate of total evaporation, okay, for that particular week. So rate of evaporation is given in this problem is nothing but what? 1 mm per square meter per hour, okay. For 1 week, we have 7 days. So those 7 days, so that is nothing but if one day, each day is having 24 hours, 7 day into 24 hours, 168 hour duration. Okay, for 1 hour, 1 mm evaporation takes place. So for 1 hour, 1 mm evaporation takes place. For 168 hours, so 160 mm the evaporation takes place, which is nothing but what? 0.168 meter evaporation, right? So then we have pan coefficient is equal to lake evaporation by pan evaporation, that is EL by EP. Okay. So EL is equal to EL we have to calculate. Okay. EL we have to calculate. EL is equal to EP into pan coefficient, which is nothing but 0.168. Okay. So this is nothing but 0.168. Just now we have calculated here into 0.8. 0.8 is given. Okay. That is nothing but what? Pan coefficient. Okay. Pan coefficient value. So 0.134 meter is nothing but what? The lake evaporation data. Okay, so using that we can able to calculate total water loss due to evaporation. So that is nothing but if you are knowing the water spread area, multiplying with the EL data, so we can able to calculate what is the total water loss. So 2 hectare is the area, 2 into 10 to the power of 4 meter square into 0.134 meter. So 2680 meter cube is nothing but what? Total water loss due to evaporation. Total water loss due to evaporation. This is very simple. Okay. So just we have to know, we have the concept of rate of evaporation. So by that we can able to calculate what is the total evaporation for total duration of hours in that particular week. So which is nothing but 0.168 meter. Using the pan coefficient data, so now we can able to calculate what is the total water loss due to evaporation. Okay. Right. Understood, Sandesh? Fahim, Sajad, Anas? Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Now you can copy that. Copy the same on your notebook. Yes, Sajjad, it's over.
Yes, sir.
Fahim, it's over.
Yeah, over, sir.
Yes, understood now, Fahim. Yes, okay. Any doubt is there? Sajjad? Anas?
No, sir.
Okay. So we will proceed further, right? Just to copy this problem now. So what is given here in this problem? During a daily routine observation, 10.8 liters of water was added to bring the water surface in the evaporation pan to the stipulated level. Okay, that's what I was explaining about. Okay, so to maintain the constant water level, we must add the water if it is in less. If excess amount of the water is already present, we have to remove that. Okay. And the nearby rain gauge measured 3.6 mm of rainfall. So rainfall has also occurred in that particular place. What was the evaporation recorded for the day? Okay. If the diameter of the pan is 122 centimeters. So diameter of the pan is also given here, as well as rainfall data or the precipitation data also with us. And the water lost, or that is nothing but water added to bring the water surface in the evaporation pan to the stipulated level is also given. So that is nothing but 10.8 liters. So we must calculate it now. What is the total evaporation from the pan? Okay. It is pan evaporation. It is nothing to do with the lake evaporation. Just you remember that, because no data related to the lake which is given here, either water spread or pan coefficient, nothing is mentioned here. Okay. So diameter of the pan is nothing but what? 122 centimeter, as we can see here. Okay, 122 centimeter. Area of the pan we can calculate because it is nothing but what? Circular section. As I already explained in the working principle of the pan evaporimeter. So that is nothing but what? Circular cross section area. This is nothing but area is equal to 5 by 4 into d square. So 122 square. So 11689.87 centimeter square. You just calculate using your calculator. Okay. Just to verify the answer, these answers simultaneously. Volume of the water added is equal to 10.8 liters. Okay. 10.8 liters in the sense 10.8 into 1000 centimeter cube. Okay. So cc. Okay. So 10,800 cc, it is cubic centimeter, centimeter cube. Depth of water added is equal to what? Because you know that volume is equal to normally area into length or depth. Okay, so the depth normally. Okay, that is nothing but what? Another dimension. So here we have to calculate the depth. So depth is equal to volume divided by area, volume divided by area. Okay, so just we have to do that. So to calculate the depth of water added, so 10,800 whatever we have calculated divided by the area of the pan is in the beginning we have calculated. Okay, 11,689.87, so it comes out to be 0.924 centimeters. Okay, 0.924 centimeters. Then rainfall occurred in that particular area is given 3.6 mm. So, which is nothing but 0.36 centimeters. Okay, 0.36 centimeter, because all these data should be having one unit. So, likewise, you have to convert. Okay. So, finally, evaporation is equal to depth of water added plus rainfall. So, that is nothing but depth of water added plus rainfall here. Okay. 0.924 plus 0.36. So, 1.28 centimeter, 12.8 mm. Okay, 12.8 mm. So that is nothing but the answer is 12.8 mm or 1.28 centimeters, because ultimately we are adding 0.924 plus 0.36, because it is clearly mentioned that water has been added. Okay, so depth of evaporation is equal to, so 0.924 plus 0.36, ultimately we will be getting 1.28 centimeters. Okay, just you copy now. Sajjad, understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Copy the same thing now. Is that over, Sajad?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next problem. So last problem we'll discuss, today's last problem. So what is the evaporation if 4.75 liters of water is removed from an evaporation pan of diameter 1.22 meter? Diameter of the pan is given and the simultaneous rainfall measurement is 8.8 mm. Okay, so what is given here? What is the change? So in the previous problem, water was added. Here it is clearly indicated that water is removed. Okay, water is removed to maintain the constant water level. So similar technique we have to adopt now. So diameter of the pan is given 1.22 meter. Using that area of the pan, we have to calculate. Okay. So then volume of the water removed, we can able to calculate here because it is nothing but what in terms of liter is given 4.75 liters. So we have to convert and express in terms of cc. Then depth of water removed is equal to, you know that volume divided by area only. So volume divided by area, if you do 0.406 centimeter or 4.06 mm, it will come. So then rainfall is given here in this problem. So 8.8 mm. Okay, 8.8 mm. Okay. 8.8 mm is given. So then finally evaporation is equal to, so this is nothing. Okay, so just scratch this one. Okay, this is nothing to do with this 0.36 centimeter. Okay, so here evaporation is equal to rainfall minus depth of water removed. Okay, rainfall is nothing but 8.8 minus 4.6. Okay, so 8.8 is nothing but the rainfall occurred because it is asked that what is the water removed. Okay, amount of the water removed, it is given here. That is 4.75 liters. Okay, we have to calculate now evaporation using the that data. So depth of water removed data. Okay, from the rainfall. So rainfall 8.8 minus 4.6. Okay, mm. So ultimately the answer will be 4.74 mm. Okay, 4.74 mm. Okay, understood? Sandesh, Sajad.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is very similar to the previous problem. So we have in the previous problem, what is the depth of the water added? So we will be calculating that one. By knowing that one, we have to add to the rainfall. Here we have to deduct. Okay, that is only the change, right? So understand and copy the same thing. Is that clear, Sajib, Fahim, Muhammad Islam, Sajad?
Yes, sir.
Understood, no? Copied?
Last line, sir.
Yes, Fahim? Written, no? Okay, 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 okay. So copy this problem on your notebook, and once again you can practice, okay, by seeing that problem statement. basic thing you have to understand here, it is nothing but how to calculate the evaporation by knowing the water added or water removed quantity, okay, but from the rainfall data. So as well as the application of the pan coefficient, you have to understand that is nothing but lake pan evaporation divided by lake evaporation, sorry, lake evaporation divided by pan evaporation, EL by EP. That also you have to know that definition. Using that concept, so these problems can be solved. Okay, so I'm ending this meeting. Okay, thank you. So we'll meet in the next class. Okay.